know, a lot of people think there's a fastball on the outside corner at some point. This ball club, they're pining for a double-A or triple-A team here. I don't think it'll ever happen.
The entire offseason has been shifting over from becoming an independent league ball club to now the triple-A affiliate of the Minnesota Twins. And
what a race!
I was a jerk before this. I'm going to be a jerk after this.
Obviously, a lot has happened since 2020 and heading into the 2021 season. The Saints have become a AAA affiliate of the Minnesota Twins as part of a much larger overhaul of minor league baseball by major league baseball.
Came as a shock to some, not to all. So no longer will be in the American Association. We will now be, gosh, I can't even get the name down because it's the East, AAA East Midwest Division, I think.
Look, this has been an interesting offseason. 21 years I've been in this business. This will be my 15th with the St. Paul Saints. And maybe outside of the first year moving into CHS Field, there's really never been a season for me quite like this one.
We're very excited. It's a uniquely exciting situation that is really unlike any other affiliation relationship throughout all of minor league baseball. There hasn't been a scenario historically or in present time where two teams this close together have entered into an affiliate relationship.
I would tell people that on our side, and I guess I'm only speaking for myself, the job doesn't change dramatically.
We've been adamant since day one that that won't happen, and fortunately, our major league partners, the Minnesota Twins, have stood right next to us and said the exact same thing and exclaimed to fans that they don't need to be concerned about that.
Look, I understand that there are some people out there that are hesitant about this move or unsure about this move, that think it's going to change the identity of the St. Paul Saints, and it's not going to matter what I say, right? It doesn't matter what I say in telling you that we're not going to change, that things are going to be the same.
We're definitely not changing. I think, if anything, we're going to try and be a little bit more off the cuff than normal just to prove that this partnership is awesome and it's great and we're super excited for the new experience, but we're still going to be the same. Like, our brand is always going to be Fun is Good, and fun is always going to be the thing we promote the most.
But I get that there are some people out there that are not going to hear what I have to say, are not going to believe it, that think things are going to dramatically change. They're probably the same people that think we've dramatically changed since from being in Midway to here at CHS Field. I would argue if we've changed for the much better.
We're going to have to prove that the prices won't change. We're going to have to prove that the same feeling of walking into the ballpark last year or 3 years ago is going to exist when they walk through the gates and enter the ballpark now.
And it's going to be some excellent baseball, but also hopefully our promotions and in-game entertainment will continue to be excellent as well. So being able to marry the two, I think it's going to be super fun and exciting.
The biggest fear in this transition has been that the culture of the Saints as an organization and the fan experience might change, because there's a concern that we may become more corporate as part of MLB, as an affiliated franchise.
They think things are going to dramatically change and be different, and I cannot reiterate this enough. They're not.
To prepare for the 2021 season, there have been so many different layers of activity and governance.
You know, I tell people that the 6 weeks to about 2 months before the season actually starts, and we're in that part right now as we talk, are the most hectic time of the year. More hectic than the actual baseball season. There's a lot of things going on and people have their hands in a multitude of different things. And so it's hectic. I mean, this is a time of the year where the rest of your life gets put on the back burner.
So we are, I would call it behind the eight ball relative to where we are in the process of preparing for a season.
We've been really busy with season tickets as well as mini plans.
Lots of Zoom calls, lots of communication, lots of understanding of what we're working with. Working with our new friends across the river, the Twins, and understanding what we've gotten ourselves into when it comes to ticket-related systems, from websites to marketing campaigns to getting things cleared through MLB and how that's going to work. We're learning a lot.
It feels like we're trying to do so many things with like our hands cuffed behind our backs, but now it's thinking of things that we do in a normal season as to do we need to switch it up for some COVID protocols and cleanliness, or are we still able to execute it?
Guidelines. We're going to have an understanding of what we're looking at for social distancing guidelines. We've got some new ones that came in on Friday, so we'll work through that. It's going to be to maximize our May days of what we've got coming up here for the first 12 games of the season in May. And then beyond that, it's just trying to prepare ourselves for, knock on wood, the day we get to open the ballpark to more than 27% capacity.
Over the last 28 years, the Saints, if anything, are nimble. It's something that we take a ton of pride in, is being able to make a decision and react and turn on a dime. And we sort of live right now with our new relationship with Major League Baseball, we're sort of living memo by memo. It's, we get a memo that tells us what we can expect, we react to it, and we begin to plan around it.
A lot of steps go into getting ready for opening day. But in terms of ticketing, it'll follow a lot in terms of how we're able to market this year.
When we get to that 50% number, or when social distancing guidelines change from 6 feet to 3 to whatever that number comes in at, just having ourselves as a ticket system ready for our fans, and then just having this ballpark ready to be able to operate under 27 to 100%.
When we can have capacity restrictions released, then we'll be able to scale that same system so that people are still socially distant.
And the big million-dollar question is, well, what games are we going to have? What promotions going? And that is something we're not prepared to put out there yet, just because it's a lot of moving parts, but it's hard not being able to put them, you know, in spots yet. So it's an ongoing process. It's going to continue to be an ongoing process, and I understand the frustration with people not knowing, because they always want to come out for Star Wars night, or they really love Dog Day, and we're not able to disclose that information yet, and people want to buy tickets, so.
Overall, my job doesn't change. It's now dealing with an organization that has they will tell us who our players are and our coaching staff, and then getting to know a brand new group of players. I'm recognizable because of what I do, but people don't understand the other side of things. When we get fans that call in that are diehard Saints fans, and I answer the phone, most of the time they're pretty surprised at the fact that I'm answering the phone, helping them out with ticket calls or whatever. But that's what minor league baseball is. That's what I've done for 21 years.
The Twins want this partnership for any number of reasons, but one of the reasons that they wanted to be a part of the Saints organization and partner with the Saints is because of our 28-year history of being who we are.